I'm going to bring up right now Deborah Wang of Asian Services in Action. Come on, Deborah Wang.
Hello, like Congresswoman Fudge just said, my name is Deborah Wong. It's spelled funny. I'm from Asian Services in Action. We're a health and human services agency serving the immigrant and refugee communities of Akron and Cleveland. And I just want to thank Representative Fudge for holding this event today and for letting me share a little bit about what we're doing to register voters in our communities. All of the incredibly empowering information that I've heard shared here today about absentee voting, about the voter registration deadline, about what's happening with voter suppression in this country, it's not information that is available to a large number of our communities because of language barriers. Many members of the Chinese community, of the Southeast Asian community, of the recent refugees from Bhutan and Burma who have settled here are limited English proficient. They don't have access to this information, and without, information is power, right? So without access to that information, they can't take action like we can to change that situation. There are about 68,000 AAPIs, Asian American Pacific Islanders, in the Cleveland metropolitan area. 67,000 eligible AAPIs are registered to vote in the state of Ohio. That's about 40%. It's too low. So what Asia is trying to do, we have a statewide voter registration initiative going on in Cleveland, Akron, Cincinnati, Dayton, and Columbus, and up in Lorain on Oberlin College campus. We're passing out the national voter registration form, which is available in several Asian languages. Asia has also developed a voter guide in English and in six different voter Asian languages, and I'm about to go offer those to the Board of Elections here. And we have been... I have Chinese, Korean, Vietnamese, Japanese, Nepali, and Punjabi are coming soon. And we have been in cooperation with APIA Vote and with the Organization of Chinese Americans of Greater Cleveland, we've been holding voter registration drives in Asia Plaza and in Asian Town Center. I'm sure you're all familiar with those areas. So we're holding those every weekend from now until October 9th. So please come out, support us. Thank you very much.
Thank you very, very much. We're going to have Pastor Harris, the Chair of Pastors in Mission, come up and say a few words, and then I see we've been joined by the Minority Leader of the State House, Armond, and we'll call him up next. Come on, Pastor.
Right. Congresswoman Fudge, it's good to see you again. Witnessing you last week in that panel, you did a great job and really brought home our cause. It's critical right now that we vote. It's just a critical issue. A lot is going on to take our vote away from us in very sophisticated ways. And a lot is being formed against us in order to stop us from getting to the poll. It was no two ways about it. In 2008, we were so successful. We lined the street, wrapped lines around the street, back down the street, just to get out to vote. And being that successful, somebody wanted to stop us on this time around. But I read something in the word of the Lord.
All right, Reverend Harris.
I think I was in Isaiah 54, the verse was 17, and it said something like this: no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Can I get a witness? Can you help me say that? No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Can we say it one more time? No weapon formed against you shall prosper. And then can you say this? It won't work.
It won't work.
I like what the mayor said about getting 10 people registered. I think we need to tell 10 about whatever is necessary to make sure that they know about voting and make sure that they're registered. And then I think we need to touch 10 to make sure that they take time out to register and be ready to vote. And then last but not least, I think we need to take 10. Can I get a witness? If we take 10, make sure, don't vote by yourself. Turn to your neighbor, say neighbor. It's Sunday morning now. Turn to your neighbor, say neighbor. Don't go vote by yourself. Take somebody with you. Turn to your other neighbor, say other neighbor. You better vote. Your life and my well-being depend on it. And I want to close like this. I'm David Ruffin, and these are the Temptations.
Come on, Armond and Budish, minority leader.
I gotta follow that, huh?
We can do it!
All right! It's great to see so many of you here. It's my pleasure to join our congresswoman who has been fighting for our right to vote in Washington for months and months now, and I will tell you that it is necessary. John Barnes and I spend our time in Columbus, and I can tell you it's been rough down there. The Republicans in the majority, the governor, the Secretary of State, who's now called the Secretary of Suppression, has been doing everything he can to keep people from voting, to keep Democrats from voting. They've changed the hours for voting. They've changed the days for voting. They've changed the ways for voting. They've passed photo ID bill in the House. They've done all kinds of things to try to make it harder for Democrats to vote. The one thing they can't take away is our energy and our resolution. We are going to vote. We are going to vote. We are going to vote. We need all of you to make sure people get out to vote. Talk to your neighbors. Talk to your friends. We've got to overcome what the Republicans are doing to try to slant this election. You see the polls. President Obama's ahead. Senator Brown is ahead. But those are based on likely voter polls. If they change who the likely voters are by suppressing our votes, those polls mean nothing. We have to get out and vote. Thank you all very much. Thank you, Congresswoman Fudge.
Thank you so much, Ron. I think that, let me see who that is that was actually on the program. Oh, hey, Mayor Jackson, hey. And Mayor Ifill is here too, so what, come on up. Come on, Mayor, real quickly, then we'll go to our mayor. We're gonna close out with Mayor Jackson complete.
Oh, thank you, Congresswoman. I just wanna thank the Congresswoman for having this event. I think that it's very important for all of us to work hard to get people out to the polls to vote. This is a really important election, as you've heard from so many other people, and I'm going to turn this over to Mayor Jackson.
Thank you. So before we do that, Richard Romero is here from our Latino community. I want Richard to say a few words. Richard Romero.
Thank you. I wear many hats. I'm a state commissioner on the Commission on Latino Affairs. I work across the state of Ohio. I'm also the publisher of Latino Magazine. But the most thing I'm most proud of, I am the Latino fan club of Marcia Fudge. But here's a few numbers I want you to keep in mind, and it really touches on what everybody said about registering voters and getting people out to vote. There's going to be over 12 million Latino vote in this election, but here's the scary and sad opportunity that we need to tap into. There are 23 million that are unregistered.
Wow.
So that's very sad. And then do you know that 1 in 10 people do not have a government ID? So some of the laws that they're creating, you know, the statistics are that's 800,000 people that would be left out. So, you know, those are things to think about. But I want to also tap on to what she said with registering them. I think we have to push as long and as hard as we can to register everybody. But here's the real deal. We got to get them out to vote. So I'm going to also pick up on what the gentleman here said about 10. I'm going to pick up on that thing because look at it. I've got 20 members in my family that are adult and that are registered to vote, but not always they vote. So I'm going to make it my job to make sure that every single one of them, now you imagine, and I'm going to ask them to do a favor for me, and they're my brother and they're my sister and my nieces and nephew. I'm going to tell them that they have to get 10 more. So now my 20 becomes 200.
That's right.
And that's what it's going to take. Right. So I represent 200 votes because I'm going to get out there and vote. Now they said that this last election in 2008 that we came out because we wanted to make history. And you know, and we did. But this election is not only about making history. This is our moment. This election is about us. This election is about our family.
Right.
So we need to go out there and say, hey, go out there and do it for you. Do it for your family. Because if we don't get it right this time, we're in a whole lot of trouble like everybody else said. So thank you very much, and let's get out there and vote.
We will. All right.
Councilman Singh, how many Sikhs are in our community? 10,000 Sikhs. Come on, say a few words. Before you do that, we have a couple of organizing for America Obama people here. Wave your hands, Obama folks, who are actual employees of the Obama campaign.
Good afternoon, America. If you look around, I'm the youngest American here. I'm only 12 years old. But we have 10,006 in Northeast Ohio. And and she's a very good advisor. She's helping me to set up the Sikh Democratic Club. And I just realized that only 30% of us are registered.
Wow.
So I was just talking to my friend there, the Reverend. And I said, can you help me to get all my people registered within 2 weeks? And we're very proud to be Americans.
That's right.
And we're very fired up, not only about President Obama, but you know, we're also very fired up about Michelle, because she's the first lady in America who can do our dance, the Bhangra dance. My daughter is so excited. Every time she sees her, she gets so excited. She said, Michelle, Daddy, Michelle! And I have to drop everything, even if I'm in the toilet. She said, Michelle Obama is right there. Because she's the only one who can, and she always tells me, she's the only one who can do the Bollywood dancing. And she does it better than our president, but you know. And President Obama means much more to us. Because he's the first person who can relate to us.
Mm, that's right.
Yeah,
right.
That's right. He looks like us. I mean, of course, I'm better looking than him. But he looks like me, same color as me.
Yeah.
And he grew up in a place very close to where I grew up. I'm originally from Singapore, and he grew up in Jakarta. And I've been to the neighborhood where he grew up. So I can't even control my emotions every time I see President Obama. And on my daughter's birthday wish this year was, she said, I want to see him in person. So on her whole birthday was spent at the rally in Akron.
All right.
So we need your blessings, we need your help, and we're going to get a vote out. Thank you so much.